experienced Arnulfo Castorena has been a medalist in this event in the last six World Championships, stretching all the way back to 1998. A gold, two silvers and three bronze. So Leah Heat is not going to do it this morning. But I'd like to think in his home championships he might be able to make it 7 goals.
Incredible statistic for Castellani. For an awful long time, still very successful. When Pan Mike appears, really watch out for. Sometimes see this in the medley, but as you get towards the end of the week, check out the medley. See the swimmers who are near the top of the medley. And you realise how many goals have already won through the week in their individual events. You know they're a very strong, very technical all-round swimmer. That's exactly what the Frank Camp is. The swim yesterday, the world record was absolutely brilliant. Mainly because Lopez Diaz swam an America's record in second place. He made Juan push that little bit further. And you'll know this better than most. When you're in the pool and you have got someone behind you who is swimming the race of their lives, it does make you go that little bit faster as well.
He absolutely pushed him on. He needed that little push just to break that world record. He needed to go a world record time to beat Lopez Diaz, who has been the real surprise package of these championships in this classification. Look like there is going to be a surprise here in these heats, because the world record holder is going ahead of the rest of the field. He has been chased by Castorena, the experienced Mexican who's looking in good shape. Qualifies second here. Castorena, of course, a medalist at a number of world championships in breaststroke as well, so this is very much a strength for the Mexican.
He has closed on Juan Rampan. He was quite a way ahead after the first leg of backstroke. Now, Juan is on to the freestyle. Mostly in the arms, this, for Juan Rampan. Clear water between himself and Arnulfo Castorena of Mexico. Third place currently belonging to the Swede in lane 6, Carl Fredriksson. If this is a test run for the final later on, signs are looking pretty good. And Wayne Pound to pick up another gold medal this week. Great race, Sonia, by Wang as he comes underneath the flags and into the wall, and a lot of encouragement in the stands as well for both these swimmers. Wang touches it, 258.36. That actually is a championship record for Wang Wenpan. What a stunning swim that is in the heats, as Castorena comes in second place. Big applause for the home favourite. But Wang Wenpan has gone out here in the heats. He does have the world record. He's actually a little way off that world record, but such is the speed that he has in this classification, he's taken 3 seconds or so off Dmytro Vinohradets' championship record, which has stood since Montreal in 2013. He's done it in the heats. Phenomenal swim from Juan Wenpan. Coming in third in the end, a really strong freestyle from the Greek in lane 3, Yanis Kostakis, to finish in third. Fredriksson just losing his grip on third over that freestyle, and he comes in fourth. Final swimmer to finish will be the Egyptian. And the Thai in lanes 2 and 7, Yusuf El Sayed in lane 7, he's going in to finish. Shahmin Kershi of Thailand going in to finish his race. But just take a look at the finish here from Juan Wenpan. Championship record in the heat ball. What has he got in the locker for tonight?
Well, I think he's got a lot more in the locker there. I think he's going to look for a little bit faster. Maybe not world record pace, but he is on world record form, so who knows? 2:44.19, the record he set last year in Rio, and he has really pushed on the standard of this event in recent years. He becomes the first man under the 3-minute mark. Wang Wenpan takes that one in a championship record ahead of Castorena and ahead of Kostakis. Look forward to the final this evening to see what time he's going to post then. Should be quick. SM3's next heat is the SM4's.